To find the derivative of the given natural log function in its current form, we'd have to apply the chain rule, where u, the inner function, would be the square root of a quotient. Therefore, determining u prime would be pretty involved. But what we can do is apply the property of logarithms to rewrite the function so it's easier to determine the derivative. The first thing we should recognize is that we can rewrite the square root as a rational exponent. This would be the natural log of the quotient. Raised to the 1/2 power. And now in this form, we can apply the power property of logarithms stated here, where we can take the exponent and move it to the front and multiply it by the natural log. So we can write the function as f of x equals 1/2 times the natural log of the quotient. And now that we have the natural log of a quotient, we can rewrite this as a difference of two logs stated by the quotient property of logarithms. But we do have to be a little bit careful when we do this. We would have f of x equals 1/2 times the difference of the two logs, which would be natural log of 3x to the 4th plus 2 minus natural log 4x. And now we could determine the derivative in this form, but I think it's easier if we distribute the 1/2 first. So 1/2 natural log 3x to the 4th plus 2 minus 1/2 natural log 4x. So the derivative function is going to be equal to 1/2 times the derivative of natural log 3x to the 4th plus 2. This is a 4. So we'll have to apply the chain rule, and here's the formula. So we'll let the inner function equal u. So here u would be equal to 3x to the 4th plus 2. So the derivative of natural log u is equal to 1 over u times u prime. So here we have 1 over 3x to the 4th plus 2 times the derivative of 3x to the 4th plus 2, that would be 12x to the 3rd. We'll put that over 1. Minus 1/2 times the derivative of natural log 4x. Again, we have a composite function. So here u would be equal to 4x. So the derivative is 1 over u times u prime, or 1 over 4x times 4. Now let's go ahead and simplify these products and see what we have. Here we have a common factor of 2. This simplifies to 1. This would be 6. And over here, these 4s simplify out. So it looks like we have 6x cubed over the quantity 3x to the 4th plus 2 minus, here we'd have 1 over 2x. So this is our derivative function, but normally we're expected to combine these two fractions. So let's continue this on the next slide. Well, the least common denominator of these two fractions would be the product of the two denominators. So we'll multiply this first fraction by 2x over 2x. We'll multiply the second fraction by 3x to the 4th plus 2 over 3x to the 4th plus 2. So notice our common denominator would be 2x times the quantity 3x to the 4th plus 2. And now we can combine the numerators. Here we'd have 12x to the 4th. And now we need to be careful here because we're subtracting this product. So we'd have minus 3x to the 4th and then minus 2. So we have two like terms in the numerator. So our derivative function would be the quantity 9x to the 4th minus 2 all over 2x times the quantity 3x to the 4th plus 2. Nothing factors here. And there are no common factors between the numerator and denominator. So this would be our derivative function. I hope you found this helpful.